Howdy folks, it's RJ Helms here, back with episode 24 of Let's Play Capitalism Lab. When we last left off, we had just finished the expansion into the full gamut of products in the beverage sector and had doubled up on our sofas because that seemed to be something that we just couldn't produce enough of. And we're trying to shake off these silly people who will pay ludicrous amounts. You know what, they're planning... You know, this isn't on internal sale. I thought it was, but it's not. They're just being silly people and buying this, even though they can get it cheaper from the warehouse, and I'll let them. I don't mind. We had a grape shortage, which, bam, is no longer the case, so, which was hurting our ability to produce wine and grape juice, and that problem is just solved. That's what I wanted to do first in this episode. So now we should be on our way with getting those back on the market. We are getting our R&D, or just had it tick through the next three-year iteration of furniture. And now we're expecting any minute now, well, sometime in the next couple months, the R&D of our sporting goods to come through. If we take a look at our goal, we're doing great. Same situation as before. We are having no trouble holding the line on shareholder return and operating profit. So we're just trying to grow our revenue. Seems to be where we end up in every scenario is the last goal. And something else just ran out. And we are about three quarters of the way there. My supply of oil has stopped. Well, that's unfortunate. But I can replace it. I paid a dividend, so I assume, yeah, my guy's getting pretty rich. I wonder if I'm on the Billionaires 100. No, not yet. I don't know how many billions you actually have to get to make on it, because it is obviously more than 1 billion. But, eh, doesn't matter for this scenario, just a curiosity. If you guys won't go away, I'll raise the price. I'm totally willing to be an ass. That guy just needs more training. How are you doing on... Yeah, so I just want to keep bringing this price up just a little bit. Because I want to see that, you know, my goal is to see a little bit of profit coming in every month. So let's do another tour. I know it's not the most riveting thing in the world, but... That's unnerving. What happened to my supply of beds? Timber shortage, of course. I forgot to spam this unit with... timbery things, okay. So that should sort itself out, I won't worry about it. Not helping my bottom line, but that's okay. Cotton's doing fine. To raise the price one more cent. Same thing here, I just want to try to hit zero month to month when I can. Oh yeah, that's doing wonderful. So close. Okay, how are these guys doing? I think their prices can come down a bit. That's still a milk that's being crazy. I did not expect that, to be honest. All right, we're getting there. Price of grapes planning to rise a little bit. And what's that R&D? Backpack, golf clubs. And any minute now, inline skates and polyester. Wonderful. So let's buy up some more land just to be consistent with the approach. There's inline skate. All right, so the other thing I wanted to do. Let's make these 3 years. So, backpack, 3 years. Golf club, 3 years. Inline skates, 3 years. And polyester, 3 years. So, look at the manufacturing guide. Backpack, linen, polyester, golf club, timber and iron, inline skates, or timber and steel, leather, rubber and steel. So, let's do backpacks first. Another large factory. Backpacks, sure. All I care about is that you buy the polyester from me. Which you didn't. Okay. I'm probably actually overproducing here, but okay, golf clubs. I know, don't set up links for me because you like to do it in a silly way. So the timber from me and the steel can come from anywhere. I'll go for that. No. The highest quality steel I can actually get. I suppose. No, not beds. Golf clubs. And finally, inline skates. Excuse my leather. Rubber from the seaport, sure. And steel, once again, the best I can get, which seems to be this one. Come on, steel, it's not so hard. I'll get those prices nice and low because this market is competitive. Possibly the point that trying to join was a mistake, but we'll see. And now a sports store, I guess, is what I want. Try to find a good place for it. 54. Yeah, 54. And just sell these three goods. Think of a media firm, and it seems like this advertisement is going to have to be somewhat aggressive because I'm way behind. On quality, I'm not doing so bad, but on every other metric conceivable. I have to bring things way back. And on the golf clubs. Why is the quality of my backpacks falling? This linen's terrible. Yes, I will buy this linen from the seaport. Okay, so inline skates are actually doing fine, so I'm gonna move right into it and build another one. Backpacks I'm starting to get established, but the golf clubs. Yeah, my price is okay. We should see our quality rise as the better linen gets in. And one last thing to check, do these people ever stop buying from here? No. So even higher. That's crazy. It looks like I've hit the sweet spot on the sofas. It's $128 a unit. Okay, so how are we doing for our goal? Yeah, that brought in another $50 million a year or so. We're getting there. And look at the convenience store specifically. Ah, it looks like they're part of the problem is that my grapes are crap. I have very low brand loyalty because these goods all suck. Which makes me wonder, I'm just not certain at this point, if it's worth moving into other markets with these goods, just because the quality of them is so low. How are we doing on the R&D timeline? Still another 2 years or so. So I just don't know if I want to hurt my brand loyalty in that sector in other cities just yet. I probably don't. Did I ever build footwear stores in every city? Yeah, but I might actually be able to double up on them. Price of the slogan camp can be a bit higher to make sure I break even. Burning through that reserve. Let's go to that. It's still, this is what I'm still worried about, so this can come up. You still need to come down, but I want to play for sports goods in every city. I know for sure I want to do that because my quality's not bad. It's actually not even so far off of competitive. It's just prices are very low. And my brand sucks. But we can solve all our problems. Let's do that. We'll set these up. And I think that will be this episode. 45 isn't bad. It feels like it's the best right now. Sure. Backpack. Golf club. Inline skates. Advertising unit. Same thing, I'm going to advertise quite aggressively in this market, and let's set our prices. I mean, for now, I'm just going to have to come in under the city average and take it from there. All right, Rome. $60. I'll take it. Backpack. Golf club. Inline skates. Oh, I already am under. On that one, too. Once these are all set up and have some time to start to situate, I'll circle back on them. Oh, this city's crowded. All the good land's not available here. 33. Nice job having two computer stores next to each other. 3, in fact. I guess if that's what your company does. There'd be some logic to that approach, but I don't see it. Yep, that 39 might be the one. Backpack. No, not two backpacks. You can be golf clubs. Be inline skates. Advertising. Beat the average. Beat the average. And beat the average quite handily there. Okay, now Istanbul. Land is really at a premium in a lot of these cities. Now, there's a 27 there. 9. And that 33 is the best I've seen. I'm just going to take it. And link up the media. We're back in Prague. Okay, so I'm going to look at sports stores. Just do a tour of these five specifically. And Prague actually needs some training put on it. It's not quite turning a profit, but where'd that go? But it has the potential now, so I'm okay with that. And I'm just trying to see here what's actually showing some demand and what's not. I hear actually know right away I want some more inline skates. Whereas these prices need to come down. Seems like my inline skates are actually the most competitive of all of my sporting goods. Okay, and where are we towards our goal? We are within $100 million. That's great. So I'm actually going to end this here. Sitting at just over 20 minutes, so that's exactly what we wanted to do. But I think if we play our cards right, we can win this scenario in the next episode. We'll see how we do on the convenience store if that research is due to tick over. Might be, depending on how long that lasts. But if we double up on our footwear store, which I think is going to be a very good thing to do. Okay, you can finally go back to normal price. So what was normal price? 128-ish. 127, sure. So long for making $1 billion a year, but maybe this won't lose $23 million a year. Despite having huge, huge revenues. Anyways. Yes, with any luck, we can win this scenario in the next episode. I think it should be possible, but we'll see. First order of business is going to be more footwear stores, and then we'll see how that takes us. But we'll get there when we get there. Until then, this has been Capitalism Lab. I've been RJ Helms. As always, thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to leave a comment if you have any thoughts or feedback about this episode or this series or my channel in general. And to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more things like this. And I'll see you next time. Thanks so much.